Ranibizumab is a recombinant humanized monoclonal antibody and VEGF-A antagonist used for the management of macular edema after retinal vein occlusion, age-related macular degeneration, wet, and diabetic macular edema. In this video, let's find found. What is ranibizumab? What class of drug is ranibizumab? What is ranibizumab used to treat? Who cannot use ranibizumab? What are the side effects of taking ranibizumab? How does ranibizumab make you feel? How to use ranibizumab? What is ranibizumab? What class of drug is ranibizumab? Ranibizumab, sold under the brand name Lucentis among others, is a monoclonal antibody fragment created from the same parent mouse antibody as bevacizumab. Ranibizumab was developed by Genentech and marketed by them in the United States, and elsewhere, by Novartis. Ranibizumab, Lucentis, was approved for medical use in the United States in June 2006, and in the European Union in January 2007. What is ranibizumab used to treat? Ranibizumab injection for intravitreal use is indicated to treat neovascular, wet, age-related macular degeneration, AMD, macular edema following retinal vein occlusion, diabetic macular edema, diabetic retinopathy, and myopic choroidal neovascularization. Ranibizumab injection for intravitreal use via ocular implant is used to treat neovascular, wet, age-related macular degeneration, AMD, in patients who have responded to at least two intravitreal injections of a VEGF inhibitor. Who cannot use ranibizumab? Contraindications include ocular or periocular infections and hypersensitivity. Patients who have an ocular infection, who recently underwent ocular surgery, or have increased intraocular pressures should avoid ranibizumab use. What are the side effects of taking ranibizumab? The most common side effects in clinical trials were conjunctival hemorrhage, eye pain, vitreous floaters, increased intraocular pressure, and intraocular inflammation. Pharmacodynamics. Ranibizumab is a vascular endothelial growth factor, VEGF-A, inhibitor used to manage ocular diseases with abnormal angiogenesis. It inhibits the formation of new blood vessels or neovascularization. Ultimately, ranibizumab works to slow down the loss of vision and causes significant visual improvement in patients with ocular degenerative disorders, such as age-related macular degeneration. It can also reduce retinal thickness. As ranibizumab has one binding site for VEGF, two drug molecules bind to one VEGF dimer. Ranibizumab lacks the region of an antibody, which may prevent the drug from causing intraocular inflammation following intravitreal injection. How does ranibizumab work? The pathogenesis of neovascular eye diseases is not fully understood, however, vascular endothelial growth factor A, VEGF-A, has been implicated in the development of clinical manifestations, such as choroidal neovascularization. Neovascularization is characterized by rated proliferation of abnormal vessels in the choroid capillary matrix. As a member of the VEGF family, VEGF-A is a key regulator of vascular permeability and angiogenesis, thus, it has been studied as a therapeutic target for the treatment of a wide array of neovascular eye diseases, including neovascular at age-related macular degeneration, AMD, and diabetic retinopathy. For example, increased VEGF-A levels in the vitreous were shown in patients with neovascular age-related macular degeneration. Half-life. The estimated average vitreous elimination half-life is approximately 9 days following intravitreal injection. The half-life of ranibizumab implant is approximately 25 weeks. How to use ranibizumab? The approved dose of intravitreal ranibizumab injection is either 0.3 or 0.5 mg in 0.05 ml. Dosing recommendations vary according to indications. Neovascular, wet, age-related macular degeneration, AMD. The recommended dose for ranibizumab is 0.5 mg, 0.05 ml, administered once a month by an intravitreal injection. Macular edema following retinal vein occlusion. The recommended dose for ranibizumab is 0.5 mg, 0.05 ml, administered once a month by an intravitreal injection. Diabetic macular edema, DME, the recommended dose for ranibizumab is 0.3 mg, 0.05 milliliters, administered once a month by an intravitreal injection. Diabetic retinopathy, DR, with or without DME, recommended dose for ranibizumab is 0.3 mg, 0.05 milliliters, administered once a month by an intravitreal injection. Myopic choroidal neovascularization, MCNV, the recommended dose for ranibizumab is 0.5 mg, 0.05 milliliters, administered once a month, 28 days, by an intravitreal injection for up to 3 months. Retreatment may be needed as per treatment response. Are there specific concerns about ranibizumab and pregnancy? Women are advised to wait 3 months after the last dose of treatment with ranibizumab before conceiving. Little is known about the fetal side effects of this drug. That's all the information about ranibizumab we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.